Patriot Radio News Hour, Monday, December 17th, 2012, on KXXT 1010.
Welcome to the Patriot Radio News Hour. I'm Eric Cederstrom, CEO, shipping clerk, and janitor extraordinaire. We're live from the Hole in the Ceiling Studios, beautiful, vacant Deer Valley, Arizona, after a very wet, rainy weekend on this 17th day of December 2012, the year of our Lord. And this show is brought to you by us, as it has been now for 20 years, next year, the Patriot Trading Group. We offer gold and silver. That's all we do. We don't do anything else. We do it better than anybody, in spite of all the people every day. You have a choice of who you do business with. We thank you when you choose us. And you can do that by 1-800-951-0592. You can go to our website at 24/7 at allamericangold.com. That, of course, is updated by Heidi the Web Babe daily, with news to comfort the disturbed and disturb the comfortable. And I actually cringe to use either one of those terms this morning. I'm joined with nephew, vice president, business partner, and co-host Joe Jaquin sitting across from me. And this is a show today that neither one of us want to do. And you turn on the radio or the TV, and, of course, it's dominated by the tragedy in Connecticut. And, of course, it's also dominated by the liberal media and the push now to take away another freedom from law-abiding Americans. Good morning, Joe. How are you?
Somber. And it is amazing, the media play on all of it. And I think they're missing a big piece of it. I really do. We kind of talked about it this morning.
Well, this show and the roots of this show right here that you're listening to, a lot of you people in Colorado know that have been listening for be 20 years for me next year. That came from a great patriot and a great man, Dr. Norm Resnick. And I did my first interview with him in 1993, and I sponsored him until he passed away. He's no longer with us. But I actually seeked him out because Norm Resnick, who did this show before us, he was of the believer that the medication, that the disease that started in the 90s, the early 90s, for ADD, lack of better words, just keep throwing, there's 100 others. But the ADD, which we'll just use that as a group, the attention deficit disorder, was not a real disease.
It was
created by the pharmaceutical company. Now, I know you're going, Eric, have you lost your mind? Where are you going with this? And I believe, ladies and gentlemen, that what you're witnessing today in America is a symptom of that. And what I mean by that is that nowhere today will you hear anywhere. Of course, there was an article written that the NRA is guilty of murder and should be tried as co-conspirators for the murder of these defenseless children, which is an undefensible act of random violence. There's no way to defend it or rationalize it at all. But yet, you don't hear anywhere that 20 years ago they started drugging up the American children in this country, and that somehow this is all okay. You don't hear anywhere that the pharmaceutical companies should be responsible for what's happening. And these are all young adults that do this. And, of course, the schools don't want to deal with them. The state don't want to deal with them. They want to put your children on medication because the school gets more money. Again, where am I going with it? It's a symptom. It's a symptom. And it's the whole thing. This is unfixable, and it certainly isn't guns' fault. I mean, you look at the Ritalin Society and what these kids have grown up with, now video games of constant, while they're medicated, they're constantly shooting things on a television screen. And I have said over and over and over again, even before I met Norm Resnick, if you listen to me on the nights, in the early 90s and on shortwave, that you can't have freedom without prosperity. And again, it's another 20-something kid with no job. Okay, they don't have a job. There's no prosperity out there. And it's the whole no-fear soccer mentality. The whole thing, the socioeconomic destruction. And now, again, the liberals are jumping on the cause as it's, well, let's take away the guns. And you know what? They're going to get them. That's the sad thing about this whole thing. Democrats say meaningful action in the wake of the school shootings in Connecticut must include a ban on military-style assault weapons and look at how the nation deals with individuals suffering from serious mental illness. Now, again.
Oh, that, whoa. There it is.
There it is.
See? Serious mental illness. We need more drugs.
Well, they don't talk about the fact that these, and they don't release it either, and I don't know. I might be talking out of school, but I would say the kid, the tragedy in Colorado, this one, and just a host of other ones started, and these kids were on Ritalin either at the time or at one point in their life.
So, and we're using, whether it's ADD or Ritalin, some form. Group it all in there, you know, whether it was Ritalin or some
or whatever
other drug,
they put them on.
Whatever they're on. But that is exactly what, you know, when you look at it, that's what they're doing. Well, this kid's different than the rest of them. So we got to do something because, well, I don't want to deal with them. I'm a teacher. I don't want to deal with them. The school doesn't want to deal with them. The parents, where are the parents in all of this? They don't want to deal with it. And they think that somehow by giving them this magic pill that everything's going to be better.
And don't tell me about profiling because it exists. That's how I found Norm Resnick. Because they tried to put both of my daughters, the schools did, both of my daughters, you know, one probably we should have, but we didn't. But they've tried to put both of them on Ritalin. Said our youngest was autistic. She was eligible to graduate from high school early, by the way. So they were 100% wrong. But again, the schools get more money if you're a problem child. They should have been paid a fortune for me. But now the Democrats and the lawmakers and even independent senators, Joe Lieberman said it was time to take a deeper look into the recent spate of mass shooting and what can be done to prevent them. Gun control is the number one topic. We'll be back.
Do you owe money to the IRS? Stop worrying and start learning about what options you have. If you just want to talk to someone about your IRS debt or want specific advice, I invite you to call me, Dave Isaac, at 602-625-3074. That is 602-625-3074, CPA and former government tax auditor.
In today's environment, short sales, foreclosures, and bankruptcy seem to be the norm and not the exception. These events can be devastating emotionally as well as financially. But just when you thought it was over, you might start to wonder about the tax consequences of short sales, foreclosures, and bankruptcy. Tax law can be very complex, and it would be critical to understand the tax laws surrounding your situation. Call Dave Isaac, CPA and former government tax auditor, at 602-625-3074. 602-625-3074 to discuss your situation. He looks forward to talking with you.
We're changing somebody's world from the other side of the radio.
Have you ever wanted to be on this side of the radio? Call 602-296-3614. That's 602-296-3614 and find out how easy and affordable it is to be a part of KXXT Radio. Spread the message of hope and good news of God's Word. Call 602-296-3614. That's 602-296-3614. Come and join us today.
Hi, this is Bobby Denneke with Coldwell Banker Residential Brokerage, and I was born and raised in Arcadia and Paradise Valley, and I would be honored if you would trust me to sell your home or help you find your new home. Please give me a call at 602-819-2885. That's 602-819-2885. Thank you very much. God bless you.
Justice Hour. I got a feeling after this show you're either going to love me or hate me. I don't think there's going to be any in between. But a lot of you people have been listening to me for years, and I mean, this hits really close to home because that's how I got on the American Freedom Network, because of Norm Resnick. When I had heard that there was a doctor out there that said that the ADD thing was made up, I called him. I said, yeah, they want to put my kids on Ritalin. He goes, don't do it. He goes, what do you do for a living? And I said, well, I'm a new struggling gold dealer in the early 90s. He says, well, I need an advertiser. So that's how I met him. And I got to tell you, this no fear mentality, you know, and I still think about that. I look at these kids, and they're still out there. And this was a generation that I believe the pharmaceutical companies created, along with the schools. I mean, the kids can't get swats anymore. We've talked about that ad infinitum. There's no discipline. There's absolutely nothing. The teachers can't do anything, and the parents, if they do, sue them. They come back with attorneys. And I still think about driving a 1964 El Camino Primer Gray when I was 16 years old with a hopped-up motor, and I thought about putting a no-fear sticker on it and going home. My dad would have slapped fear into me in 2 seconds. I can just see him right now looking at the back of my car going, no fear, no fear. I can see our football coaches.
I'll show you some fear.
I can see a football coach looking at your no fear sticker going, oh, yeah?
On that hill, Cedarstrom.
Right. How about a vice principal? How about a shop teacher? They put fear in us, ladies and gentlemen. I have to tell you, I've never told this on the air, but we moved on to a dirt road in 2001. And had we known the neighborhood, you know, Confucius say, before you move, investigate your neighbors, or the Chinese proverbs. But there was, next door was a family with 13 children, which, I don't know, really didn't bother us. But eventually they started driving, some of the older ones. And that was my first encounter with the no fear sticker. And this is a good family, very religious family, obviously lots of children. But, you know, teenage kids are teenage kids. I was one of them. I raced around on the dirt roads and I caused trouble, but I never had a no fear sticker. And when my wife would say, slow down, you people live on dirt roads understand this, slow down. You'd come out, here comes the kids roaring up the street, you try to be nice about it, slow down. Every time you drive by, this huge cloud of dirt fills up, leaves an inch of dirt on everything. And then the kids started flipping off my wife.
Well, let me tell you, when you were growing up, what would have happened?
Oh, had you flipped off the neighbor? Oh, my God, I couldn't imagine. But again, there's no ramifications at school. The kid's got the no fear sticker on the back of his car. He's flipping me off, and he's flipping off my wife as he goes by my house at 80. And you can't even see for a 10 minutes after the dirt settles on everything. So one night I was having a small get-together with a couple of customers, and here comes this car down the road, probably 8 o'clock at night, and I mean flying. Had to be doing 90 miles an hour. Goes around the corner sideways, and here comes the impending cloud of dirt. And I'm looking at my customers, and I'm looking at, and I'm like, that's it. I go, that's it. And my wife says, where are you going? I said, I'm going to go teach the neighbor fear. That's what I said. Now I'm 265 pounds. He's a little kid, and we've been battling with this kid now for about 3 or 4 months. So I did what my dad would have done. You know, I took the finger. Now you take the finger, and you poke his chest. You know, you ever come down this road again like that, and I'm poking his chest. And I probably, you know, probably gave him a nice description of what I was going to do the next time, and I went back into the house. Well, here's what happened. About 20 minutes later, the SWAT team kicked in my front door. And I'm not exaggerating. I'm not embellishing. There's no hyperbole here. They kicked in my front door. The locks went flying. They came into the backyard, weapons drawn, and started pointing them at the dinner guests and me and my family. There was the UPS van down the street. It was down
the SWAT
there,
van.
The SWAT van, and it happened quick. And they're looking at me. The minute they looked at me, I'm standing in front of a grill cooking. The weapons went down, and we're like, wow, what happened? Well, the kid went home and told, this is what happens when you put fear in them, told his parents I pulled a gun on him. How about that? This is what happens in this society.
Well, let me tell you, if you had went back a couple of decades,
instead of the SWAT team blasting your door down, the parents
would have brought the kid over
with their hands around his neck.
Right. Come apologize.
You apologize to Mr. Cederstrom. And, oh, by the way, Mr. Cederstrom, I will guarantee you my son will never, ever be doing that again.
Well, here's what happened. I know you guys have never, I never told this story on the air. So they grab me and they go, did you pull a gun on him? And they're looking at me. I'm a big guy. I'm bigger than any SWAT team guy in the room. I'm like, do I look like I need to pull a gun on the neighbor kid?
Right.
They go, come with us. So out front we go. Here's the parents and the kids standing out there, and the SWAT team guy came up to the kid with Noah, and I saw the look of fear was in the kid, and this guy put it in even more. He goes, did Mr. Cederstrom pull a gun on you? And he goes, no! He starts crying. No! But he was really mean. So anyway, they wanted me to press charges, and I didn't do it. And from that day on, no one has sped down my road. This kid now is 20, in his late 20s, has gone out of his way to shake my hand and ask me how I'm doing, Mr. Cederstrom. And I don't think I ever saw the no fear sticker ever again. But this, I mean, think of how this thing had to escalate and what could have happened. But this is the society that we're in today. And this is the exact, in my opinion, psychological profile as to where the problems are coming from. Do they want to address it? No. What does Dianne Feinstein want to do? What does she want to do? She wants to introduce gun control legislation. And this is coming. This is coming like you cannot believe, ladies and gentlemen. It's an indefensible act of violence. There's no way that you can possibly say anything about the children, all right, that there was any way that this was predictable, any way that any of this was being able to be hypothesized. It's an indefensible
action. And it can't be justified. But if we're really going to talk about the issue in its entirety, and you start to look at whether it be the shootings at the movie theater in Colorado, the mall shooting where that 24-year-old in the mall, I think it was up in Washington, this shooting here, and it's so clear. Even go back, all the way back to Columbine, where those two, I think they were 17-year-olds, with these young adults and guns and these vicious, heinous crimes. It isn't the gun. Guns have been around for thousands of years. So there's something else here, and they just don't want to look at it. They don't want to go out to the pharmaceutical companies. Why would they want to do that?
It's the whole society, man. It's all the way top to bottom. It's, again, the no fear. I hate to say this.
No fear, no faith in God. It's a godless society, all of those things.
They don't keep score at a lot of the sporting venues.
Everybody gets, that's right. Everyone gets the trophy.
Right. Everything's fine. You're, everybody's a winner. Yeah, well, guess what? When you walk out of the door of high school, you realize not everybody's a winner.
And guess what?
And this is how they deal with it.
They can't deal with it.
So here we got it all. Sunday night. Well, anyway, here in every name you can think of, Senator Chuckie Schumer said the nation will be at a tipping point now, a tipping point where we might actually get something done on gun control. And I agree with him. They're going to get it done because, again, it's indefensible. He and other Democrats, as well as Lieberman, said they want to ban the sale of new assault weapons and make it harder for mentally ill individuals to obtain weapons. How about we go back to you can't vote unless you own property? How about that? You know, that was the law at one point in this country. Lieberman said new commission would be created to look at gun laws.
Oh, boy.
As well as violence in the movies and video games. Assault weapons were developed for the U.S. military, not commercial guns manufacturers. This is the moment to start a very, very serious national conversation about violence in our society, particularly about these acts of mass violence. Senator Dianne Feinstein said she's going to introduce legislation immediately next year to ban assault weapons, as well as big clips, drums, and strips of more than 10 bullets. It can be done.
So what are we talking about? Instead of killing 20 people, you kill 10?
Well, you got to understand, it's like turning up the heat on a frog in a science project. You know, when you put him in there, at first he thinks he's in a hot tub. All right? So it just keeps getting hotter and hotter, and that's how they do it, one piece at a time. Like cigarettes, all right? 25 years ago, you could smoke a cigarette on an airplane. It was normal. You went into a doctor's office, everybody's smoking.
Including the doctor.
And then it started, including the doctor, and then it started with, no smoking on flights less than an hour.
Is that what it was?
Yeah, less than an hour. Okay, you can make it. You can go 1 hour without a cigarette. You can smoke all the way up to the gate, by the way. You can smoke anywhere in the airport. They had an ashtray when you were boarding the jetway. So, and then, of course, now, not so much.
Now you got to go out around the corner.
Dianne Feinstein, yes, this instills confidence.
Another fossil that's been there way too long.
Right, just that they can do this. They can get the gun confiscation or the assault weapons done. They can get it done. It's time for the president. Bloomberg said Obama could use executive powers to enforce existing gun laws as well as throw his weight behind legislation like Feinstein.
Right, it's okay for the gang members to shoot each other.
Yes.
But now that we have all of these rogue Virginia Tech, there's another one in the young adult society doing this. It must be the gun's fault.
Well, maybe if we just made a tectonic shift and put paddles back up on the boards, on the walls. Well, they don't teach shop anymore, do they?
No, shop's gone.
They don't teach it.
You got to go to a special school for that.
I got to tell you, though, that he's the short bus. Everything I went to make in shop, all right, I'm a motorhead, okay? Anything I went to make, what are you going to build, Cedarstrom? I'm going to build an entertainment center. That's my project for this semester. What did I turn in? A cutting board. And all that's what it ended up. It was close. All the rest of the wood got sawed up, thrown away, sanded off.
The belt sander got the better of that one.
Right, cutting board. Here's your cutting board. My mom had about 50 of the things. So...
I made a jewelry box.
Did you?
Yeah.
See, that was way too high tech for me. So that would have been a shoe.
The belt sander got the better of me.
That's what happens too. You just start sanding the thing, and now you got gouges in it. I'm like,
the belt sander was the best.
It just keeps getting smaller and smaller.
Cutting board.
So anyway. Oh, I hate to add levity to the situation, but that's just who we are. And please don't be insulted about it, but this is a very serious, serious topic. Yes, it's time now for the president to sign an executive order. I think to stand up and lead the way and tell this country what we should do.
I agree.
And not go to Congress and say, what do you guys want to do, Bloomberg said.
Oh, he's talking about just executive orders.
Yeah, not go to Congress.
Right. Let's not dig any farther into this. We've got a golden opportunity to get the guns. We've been dying to do it. We're going to be able to do it right now.
You know, there's another country that seems that that's a good idea to take all the guns from Americans. Now, I know you're thinking England, right? Well, the Bulbies, they don't carry guns. Nobody has guns over there. By the way, Arizona, everybody has guns. Everybody has them. We have the lowest crime rate in the nation, I believe. We're right at it. But here's a country that has a lot. They've got a lot at stake here, obviously. And, oh, by the way, they're communists. Not only is it appalling that these shooting massacres keep recurring, but the American government inaction is also shocking, said Hu Jin, chief editor of the state-controlled newspaper, The Global Times in Beijing, China. Isn't this a human rights disaster? Listen to this, too. This is amazing. I don't understand how American parents can put up with it. An editorial published in the Xinhua, the official government newspaper, said the blood and tears of Friday's victims demand no delay for the United States to introduce gun control. Just communists. Yes, what we fought and tried to save the American way. Now we have to hear the Chinese tell us about gun laws. How about the CEO of General Electric Friday? We'll be back.
Do you owe money to the IRS? Have you heard of possible payment options such as a partial payment installment agreement, offering compromise, or not currently collectible status? Knowing that you have options and what those options are will greatly relieve your worry and stress. Hi, my name is Dave Isaac, CPA and former government tax auditor. If you are curious as to what options may be available to you if you owe money to the IRS, my 25 years experience as a CPA may very well help you in these times of uncertainty. Stop worrying and start learning about what options you have. If you just want to talk to someone about your IRS debt or want specific advice, I invite you to call me at 602-625-3074. That is 602-625-3074. And when you call, ask for me, Dave Isaac, CPA and former government tax auditor.
I'm Joe Jaquin for the Patriot Trading Group, and my uncle and I have been protecting your wealth for almost two decades. While we may be the two dumbest guys on the radio, we believe in sound money and that old piece of paper called the Constitution. From shortwave radio and tinfoil helmets to iPods and podcasts, we've been there for you, delivering all the news of the day. From QE this to QE that, have you heard about Greece and the Arab Spring? Bankrupt cities and budget deficits, all the while making you laugh and even cry at this world gone mad. Running a gold and silver company the exact opposite way you should run a business. No salespeople, no free reports, no calling our customers, just simply treating you with honesty and respect. That's been my uncle's calling card since he started this company. And who knew by doing this, people would reorder and even call their friends. So when you're ready to protect your wealth, call us at 800-951-0592. And don't forget to listen to the show at allamericangold.com.
When back home in Tennessee recently, I met a sister in Nashville for dinner. Out in the parking lot, I admired her sporty red Mustang and was treated to a story that warms the heart. One day, Judy had spent several hours in a shopping mall. When she finished and returned to her car, two college-age gals were sitting on the curb near her vehicle. Three hours earlier, they had backed into her driver's side door. These ladies could have left a name and number on Judy's windshield. That's what most of us would have done, but they were so conscientious, they wanted to come face-to-face with the owner, accept full responsibility, and provide the needed information for covering cost of repairs. To do that, they had spent several hours in the hot sun. Isn't it good to be reminded that there are still people of principle, people who accept responsibility and are determined to do the right thing? You're listening to George Merritt's God and Country.
Radio News Hour. Thanks for tuning in. I mean, one of the reasons you listen to this show is because we never do what the rest of the country does. I mean, we put the truth out for you, and you know the quote unquote neocon shows and the Hannity and Combs and Limbaugh and all that. I mean, we just don't do it here. And this issue, you know, hits real close to home to me. And from the neighbor story of the kids, you know, I mean, they're out there. You got to deal with these kids. And this is just the sickness of society. And if we could somehow go back and put the genie back in the bottle and go, listen, you know, you don't flip off your neighbor's wives when you're 16 years old, all right? And the parents don't let you do it. In other words, they just don't stand there and do nothing about it, and the teachers don't do anything about it.
I'll tell you, as a coach, and I've coached for two decades now, the amount of parents that come up to me just for the discipline aspects of it alone are grateful because they're not getting it anywhere else, and they are. They're in the minority because they see what you see. They see the exact same thing, which is these kids are just running amok out there.
Well, you're dealing with a club mentality. You're dealing with people that pay to be in your presence. I mean, you're dealing with travel sports, competitive sports, which again are probably the best children this country has to offer. I was always amazed at the girls, and especially as they've all grown up, graduated from college, and watching them how they, you know, the rest of this country, these kids got hands down on them. Keep your nose clean, you know, do the right thing, and it's going to be like a shooting gallery for these kids. There's no competition for them when they get older. So
I mean, yeah, it's crazy. But Coach Jerry Dawson, for again, you Colorado people, but a local coach here from Chaparral High School, was the meanest, toughest guy I ever know. He was probably had the most profound effect on my life when I was growing up. But he retired a couple of years ago, and they did like a Mr. Holland's Opus thing for him, and everybody came from, you know, 30 years of graduating classes, and it was quite moving. But they interviewed him in the paper. What had changed? What had changed? And he says, well, really, to be honest with you, the kids haven't changed. The kids are still trying to get away with what they got away with years ago. He goes, but it's the parents who have changed. The parents won't discipline them. The parents don't want to deal with them. They want the school to do it. So the school says, you want us to raise your kids? Here's what we're going to do. We're going to drug them up. They give us any trouble at all, boom. And then when we do that, we get more money. How about that? That's where we're at today. You're going to hear that anywhere, any other show in the nation?
Sure not.
This week, this year, you're not going to hear it. Here comes from Eric in Phoenix. Thank you so much for your story about poking the kid. It was close to mine. And, yes, my dad did spank me before taking me to the neighbors for my apology. Your common sense will certainly keep me as a customer, wishing I had more dollars to buy with. Count me firmly in your camp, and thank you for standing firm on a rarity in a politically correct society. It was a great country while it lasted. Thanks, Eric. That's awesome. This in from Don here in Phoenix. Don, or Eric, good morning. Your statements are, in my opinion, absolutely right on the money. The kids today are drugged up to the hilt, and it does have an effect on our society. I've thought this way for years and years. Keep it up. The audience needs to hear this, even if they don't agree or like it. Don, thanks, Don. Realtor Leslie Nestigen on our Friends of Patriot. This, again, is why Friends of Patriot exist. If you want to do business with like-minded individuals, this is where you go. You put it back where you found it. Eric, you are so right. The pharmaceutical industry has the blood on their hands. You are the only stand-up, honest, brave hero who cries, the emperor has no clothes. Amen. God bless you. Thank God for you. Thanks, Leslie. I appreciate that. This came in here from Jeremy in Graham, North Carolina. Thanks for being live today. It helps when everything else is a tragedy in Connecticut. Meanwhile, the price of silver is not even worth looking at it, $32.10. I telephoned another dealer. He's selling American Eagles at $38. What a disconnect. We can save you some money here. So call us. I'll get you. Let's give us a quote on silver, $4 over.
Yeah. So right now, so you'll be looking about $36. So $720 versus $760.
Yeah. So $36 here on Silver Eagles. Silver Eagles have big premiums on them, though. So
well, yeah, U.S. Mint. You can thank them for it.
1-800-951-0592. I know. I mean, the fiscal cliff thing, really? Forget that. That's just chewing gum for the mind. That's like a Y2K issue. The real issue was buried in the Wall Street Journal on page 4 today. As far as the U.S. credit rating firms are concerned, Washington can send this country over the fiscal cliff anytime they want. Holding their fire for now, the firms are keeping a much closer eye on a much bigger issue. And whether another looming debate is resolved, the need to raise the U.S. debt limit by February or March. Wall Street and Capitol Hill are on the edge over lawmakers' ability to reach the budget deal before year-end. But recent conversations between Barack Hussein Obama and Speaker John Boehner have hinted at a possible breakthrough to avoid the coming spending cuts. Yes, Boehner has now said what? Okay, we'll tax the millionaires.
Tax the millionaires.
And you hand out less food stamps. Or less entitlement.
Less entitlement and spending cuts. And one of the things that they're talking about is the quote-unquote loophole. You know, writing off the interest on your house, getting rid of that. The ability to write off your state taxes. In other words, if you're in a state, I don't know, let's just pick the big California, the biggest state in the country, the ninth largest economy in the world, just raised their state income tax to 13.3%. Right now, they can write that off. So if you make more than $250,000 a year, according to John Boehner over the weekend, you are now going to pay 39.9% in federal income tax before deduction.
One of the loopholes they're looking to get rid of is the state loophole deduction. Now, this is quite interesting because Joe had to kind of explain it to me a couple of times. So let's say your state has a 10% tax.
Okay. Yep.
And you're paying right now 40% tax. You're really rich, and this is what you're going to pay now next year.
Yeah, 39.9. Let's call it 40%.
You're really rich, really rich. You're making how much over
250?
Over 250 is.
And you got to be married.
Or is it over 200?
Well, you got to be married,
right,
to make 250. If you're single, 200.
Now, let me see. What can you really? The 250 now.
Mm-hmm.
The 250 now. All right, now. So you get to deduct. You get to deduct the state taxes you pay. So you pay 10%. You pay $25,000, let's say, to the state
of
California.
Let me just do the new law because they went to 13.3. You make $250,000.
Okay.
You're paying $33,250 to the state of California.
Goes just to California.
Just to California. Now,
so out of that $250,000, there goes $33,000.
Right, but you could take that $33,000. And deduct that.
Right, because you owe the IRS 40%.
Correct.
On 250.
Correct.
Which is 40, 80, it's $100,000.
$100,000.
So you owe them $100,000.
Right.
So you pay them $100,000. All right, but.
You get to deduct the $33,000.
That you paid California.
Correct.
So you really only owe them, you know, 60-something thousand. Let's hold on. I want people to think about that. Well, you're muddling over fiscal cliff. We'll be back.
Do you owe money to the IRS? Stop worrying and start learning about what options you have. If you just want to talk to someone about your IRS debt or want specific advice, I invite you to call me, Dave Isaac, at 602-625-3074. That is 602-625-3074, CPA and former government tax auditor.
In today's environment, short sales, foreclosures, and bankruptcy seem to be the norm and not the exception. These events can be devastating emotionally as well as financially. But just when you thought it was over, you might start to wonder about the tax consequences of short sales, foreclosures, and bankruptcy. Tax law can be very complex, and it would be critical to understand the tax laws surrounding your situation. Call Dave Isaac, CPA and former government tax auditor, at 602-625-3074. 602-625-3074 to discuss your situation. He looks forward to talking with you.
Hello, I'm Dr. G with CSI. Create success intentionally. Never since the Great Depression has America been so broke. With the political confusion and economic downturn, millions of Americans have lost their homes, their jobs, and the largest percentage of their retirement funds. Even as I speak, 74% of Americans are suffering anxiety and depression over their financial situation. My mission with Gary Lawrence Live is to enable everyone to learn how to gain their mental, emotional, spiritual, and financial freedom, with the underlying premise being, if you're in financial bondage, you're in mental and emotional bondage. It's not fun being broke. You may have just enough money coming in to keep you broke. There is a solution. Join me, Dr. G, with Gary Lawrence Live, right here on 1010 KXXT, Monday through Friday, 1 o'clock till 1:30. And remember this, the best investment for all of your tomorrows is one day wisely spent.
Patriot Radio News Hour, thanks for tuning in. My email is blowing up, patriot77@AOL.com. So, who's this? Your pilot pal from Deer Valley Airport. Since we are being politically incorrect today, telling the truth. Oh, I should probably read it before I put it out. So,
All right. Getting back to these loopholes, and then we'll get back to being politically incorrect. There's all the states are allowed when you pay your income tax for the states. There's some states, obviously, that don't have state income tax. I think there's 9 of those, but the rest of them do, and you can write that off. 5 states compose most of this. Now, at some point during these budget talks,
We eventually got to get down to real money. Taxing the rich is wonderful and it sounds great, but it's about $40 billion, maybe $50 billion. Not enough to do any type of damage whatsoever. Eventually, we're going to have to get to real numbers. This loophole is a real number. You're talking about $500 billion. Five states compose the vast majority of this, and obviously you know the states, California, New York, New Jersey, anywhere where Washington, D.C., where real estate is high. But if you're making, let's just say you're married, you got $250,000. You just hit that
number.
Well,
just about every doctor, attorney, right? Just about every one of them.
Now, you pay now 39.9%. That's going to be the new number. All of us know that. That's already been conceded.
Yeah, Boehner's
already said it. California just raised their state income tax to 13.3%. If you aren't allowed to deduct that any longer.
Now, this is part of the Obama budget talks.
Getting rid of the loophole. Now, this is just one loophole.
Well, it's essentially double taxation. So you got to pay the state and pay the feds, but it's all one bill.
Correct.
Now they want to make them separate bills.
That's right.
Wow.
Separate bills.
So what do the numbers look like?
$250,000 before tax.
Okay. You make $250,000. Nice job.
Hey.
You work right, hard.
You're a winner.
Yep.
$117,000 will be your take-home pay.
What?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
Come on.
$117,000 after you paid your state and federal taxes.
Wow. Wow. Why? Who would do that? Why even stay?
Well, that's a huge debate. And all of these states, New York, New Jersey, California.
You know what's going to happen? The people are like, here, I want to pay you. All right, here, I want to pay you to take out my kidney. No, I don't want to do it. Why not? You're going to make $80,000. If I make $80,000 taking out your kidney, I got to give it to California. I'd just soon go fishing this weekend.
Right.
Lots of luck.
It's unfixable. But I'm giving you an example. This is a real number. This is a number that actually could have some kind of effect and move the needle on the deficit problem. There's no way that could happen. You know, why work any longer?
I know.
Why even be a success?
Right. You're going to give two-thirds of it back to the, here you go, to the people that aren't working. By the way, I am going to read this. Hi, Eric, your pilot pal from Deer Valley Airport. Since we're being politically incorrect today, and he puts in parentheses telling the truth, that is what happens. God told the Jewish people that one sign of a godless generation would be that children would oppress them. Youths oppress my people, and women rule over them. Isaiah 3:12. Mike, thanks, buddy. And by the way, my list of pilot friends at Deer Valley is growing.
It's growing. It is.
I got a half a dozen of them over there now.
So
you're like an honorary member. Well, if you want to fly in and grab your gold, I mean, I'm only a mile away. We'll actually come pick you up. So I have one of my pilot friends says he's going to fly me over northern Arizona, like 20 feet off the ground, and we're going to chase stuff. So I can't wait for that. So anyway, 1-800-951-0592. If you're a new listener, we've been doing this. It'll be 20 years for me in 1993 at the American Freedom Network. If you count shortwave, I'm now over 20 years and definitely politically incorrect today. I've said the reason to buy gold is because of the socioeconomic destruction in America. That is my sole driving motivation for you people. It isn't profiteering or you're going to double or triple your money. It's to be able to have things that are put away and that are real that will work as wealth insurance. Obviously, physically and morally, you're on your own. And really, when you think about it, the only thing that stops any of us from going crazy is more morality. I mean, it's either in you or it isn't, all right? That's the one thin line that keeps us all. It isn't laws. It isn't the government. It isn't the police. Okay, it's morality. It's things that were bred into us as a society. They've taken that out. You think? Let me ask you a question. This is probably one of the most terrible statements I'll ever make, but do you think that when gunmen are rolling the the hallways of schools or movie theaters, and you see it coming, and you see them firing that you're an atheist at that moment? No. They need to put God back in the school where he belongs. Not only because of the shooter was raised without it, but, you know, maybe this is another symptom of that. I don't know.
I think it's a whole lot deeper than that. Let me ask you, if anybody out there older than 50,
I am.
Think back to when you were in high school and you drove to school, especially if you're in the Midwest or and you drove to school during deer hunting season. How many of you drove into the school, your high school, with a gun rack in the truck with your gun? How many did it?
Me, I did it. The announcement at school was if you're going to bring your guns to school, make sure you lock your vehicle. That was the announcement. But it was normal. But we did not deer hunting. We did it for dove hunting out here, September 1st. Had a 12-gauge hanging in the back of my 59 F-100. But you know
so
what?
The issue isn't the gun.
We had guns when we were 12 or 13.
The issue isn't the gun. My whole point is the issue's not the gun.
No, it's not. No, it's the fear thing. I'm convinced. I mean, if you don't fear the people that raise you, all right, then you have to have an element of fear and respect. And if you don't fear your God, you're an idiot.
You're an absolute
idiot. Otherwise, you don't have any morality. You deserve what you get. We'll be back.
Do you owe money to the IRS? Stop worrying and start learning about what options you have. If you just want to talk to someone about your IRS debt or want specific advice, I invite you to call me, Dave Isaac, at 602-625-3074. That is 602-625-3074, CPA and former government tax auditor.
In today's environment, short sales, foreclosures, and bankruptcy seem to be the norm and not the exception. These events can be devastating emotionally as well as financially. But just when you thought it was over, you might start to wonder about the tax consequences of short sales, foreclosures, and bankruptcy. Tax law can be very complex, and it would be critical to understand the tax laws surrounding your situation. Call Dave Isaac, CPA and former government tax auditor, at 602-625-3074. 602-625-3074 to discuss your situation. He looks forward to talking with you.
Hi, I'm Eric Cederstrom for the Patriot Trading Group and AllAmericanGold.com. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank all of the listeners who've supported us throughout the years and helped keep the radio stations going. I've had a chance to meet many of you face-to-face and enjoyed every minute of it. For two decades, I've worked hard to keep our service fast and our prices low, and will strive to keep going for another two. Patriot Trading Group and AllAmericanGold.com have no commission salespeople, no free reports, and no complaints. Nobody here will call you when you sit down for dinner. There really is a difference. Call 1-800-951-0592 and find out for yourself. We look forward to serving you with years of experience. We know what we are doing and will make recommendations based on your personal situation. Call 1-800-951-0592 and you'll be treated with honesty and respect. You have my word on it. I'm Eric Cederstrom, CEO, shipping clerk, and janitor.
Radio News Hour. I haven't had anyone I was expecting. I know it's coming later today. Somebody to chew me out and tell me how wrong I am. But so far, I'm not just picking the good ones. I'm just picking them as they come in. Eric, we had guns at our gun rack in school back in 83. No one killed each other because nobody was on ADD and ADD drugs. And you can actually get in a fist fight and settle the problem. The principal can still put a board to your backside, too. My dad spanked me a half a dozen times after that. All he had to do was look at me, and I straightened up. Do something bad, and there were severe consequences. Today, there are none. Joe was telling me that in the school where his boys go, if you throw a punch,
you're done.
You're gone. Zero tolerance. So now the parents come back with attorneys. Keep my kid in school. You know what? There was a fight every day when I was growing up, I would say, at school. But these were big high schools, Chaparral High School, big school. And I was in more than one.
Sure, so, that was just a part of growing up. Now are you kidding me?
I saw on the 5 o'clock news, fist fight at local school, details at 5. Here's the one I love. We'll finish with this one. I don't have time for any more. Thank you, Erin, for what so many of us have known. Our daughter wasn't reading and writing when she entered kindergarten. That was the same thing with my youngest. That's again, how I found Norm Resnick. She didn't speak till she was 3. She's a sophomore in college, by the way. Not only did she, this is back to the email, not only did she have that disadvantage, she was one of the few in the class who spoke English. Teachers and staff tried to force the ADD and meds issue, and they are very persistent, I will add. We moved to a smaller district in another state and was happy to have us. Now at 25, she is in her last year of law school. Newly married, employed, and an amateur MMA fighter. Peace and goodness to you and your listeners. April in Loveland. Thanks. That's awesome. So, yeah, this is what they have done. Now, you think they're going to address any of this? No, they're not going to. You have to hear it here. But we all know it's what it is. It's just a symptom of a sick society. So you can ban all the guns. They can do anything they want. You think it's going to stop it? No. It will not stop it. There has to be repercussions. And the problem they're at now is these kids, they want attention. They all have their own Facebook sites and essentially their own radio programs or
right.
TV shows every day. And they put their lives out there so everybody can hear them or see them. But if they don't get enough attention, this is what they do. Because why? Well, there's no repercussions. And now, if you give them attention, it'll make it worse. In other words, you parade them on TV, put them in front of a firing squad, and make a hero out of them. It's going to make it worse because there's no fear. There's no fear. Market update, Joe?
Yeah, quick look here before we head out. Mr. Boehner and the president apparently are meeting right now on this fiscal cliff. Gold's up 2 at $16.99. Silver's dead even for the day at $32.20. Platinum, palladium, really not moving as well. Crude oil's up 82 cents at $87.55. The Dow's up 70. The S&P and NASDAQ are higher as well. The dollar falling lower as the printing presses are going to continue to run. The 10-year note at 174.
We'll be at abbreviated days all week. Unless, of course, obviously, you know, the world falls apart, we'll be here for you. But 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, we're going to be gone all week. Next week, you're going to be listening to producer Cody Golden is going to pick his favorite shows. Next week are all going to be reruns. So here, right about 1 or 2 o'clock, depending on what's happening, we're going to close. And so if you want to get any orders in, do any business, buy or sell, give us a call. I'm going to ship one more time before the year is out, and then that's it. Thank you all. Thank you all for your support. Thanks for doing business with us. Thanks for keeping us on the air. Thanks for everything. God bless you all. We'll see you tomorrow. Good Lord willing. Bye now.